After listening to Robert Lang from our newsroom, the only way I can begin this discussion that will be for the last part of our show here, the C4 Show Professor, is, aren't you glad you came from California to be here with 7 degrees?
Freezing my nanays off, man.
Seven.
Oh my gosh, the temperature is like, it's not even, I was talking to my mom earlier. She goes, you know what? It used to be like in the 20s, and when it got below freezing, it's like, what's the temperature? Oh, it's like 29, it's 32. Here, it's like, no, single digits, Fillmore. Welcome back to Baltimore.
And your digits are freezing. Ladies and gentlemen, buckle up. Get ready for the wild ride that will be the end of this show, because the young man, and I'm saying that facetiously because he is older than me, the young man joining me here in studio is somebody I have known since Hilton Elementary School, even though we weren't close then.
Nope.
But in high school, at BPI, Baltimore Polytechnic Institute, we bonded, this young man and I, double dated. We can go through all of that madness if you want to. To the point where we were best man at each other's weddings, our children around the same age, all of that. But joining us here in studio is somebody who I love, and I'll say that at the beginning, I'll insult him later.
Okay.
But somebody I love very closely, my brother, Philip Moore, who is in town from California. Phil Moore is the former host of Nick Arcade, which is, we'll get into all that later. But he is here for something called MAGFest over in National Harbor in Prince George's County, January 4th through the 7th. We'll get into details of all of that so you can find out how to connect and find it out. Having said all of that, Phil Moore, welcome back home.
Hey, man, first of all,
welcome back home.
Great to be back. I always love coming back. You know, my family's still here, so I'm always popping back into town. First of all, the thing that's really tripping me out is, look at you, all grown up and talking and you're conjugating verbs and everything.
I'm like, look,
I've never seen you actually work before.
I got the old gray beard.
The gray beard's fine. We all have the gray beards, you know? I use Just for Men.
And it works very well, because I don't see any gray at all.
But, dude, I was like, you know, listening to you, I'm like, oh, my gosh, she's like using verbs and predicates.
Actually, paragraphs.
Oh, my gosh, some complete sentences.
Mr. Gross would be very happy from Polly, our English teacher.
Hilton, oh yes.
No, I really say, oh no. But anyway, Phil Moore.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, we got to say hello to your mom.
Hey.
Who we know is listening.
Nice.
Mom. He's acting nice. Off air, he's acting bad, but on air, he's acting very nice so far.
And Moore-Cooper.
Yes.
All my friends keep calling him Ms. Moore. She's like, I'll answer. That's all right.
Let's get the audience, though, acquainted with you just for a moment. Because I'm going to ask you about some stuff that's going on in the news and try to get you in trouble. But anyway, when it comes to, though, your hosting Nick Arcade, I'll never forget when you started doing this back in the day when you were first in Florida before you went to California.
Yeah.
Did you see this becoming something that now you're sought after to, like, go to these conferences and the rest of this?
No, it's crazy. Look, when I first moved to Florida, I didn't have an idea I was even going to get into business. You know, that was what my other friends did.
Right.
You know, I've got other friends here that are musicians, and they sing and compose and do all of that stuff. As a matter of fact, the last time I was in town, like about 3 years ago, I was sitting around with a couple of buddies, and they said, you know, we all thought you were going to be a scientist.
Right. Embry-Riddle aeronautical engineer.
Exactly. That's why I went down. That's why I got down to Florida. I used to build models.
Yep.
Remember coming over to my apartment?
Absolutely.
Models hanging from the ceiling. I was basically freaking Sheldon from the Big Bang Theory.
You,
you know?
Yes, you were.
And I had no idea. I moved down to Florida, did the whole thing, went to school, and then all of a sudden, man, just one day I was.
What he's leaving out is the fact that somebody encouraged him to get on stage, and it's been nonstop ever since.
This is one of those things where you got to look at bad stuff and go, what good can come out of it? Because I actually was working for AT&T down in Orlando, Florida, and they went on strike. And we're on the picket line. And it was like you and I just sitting around at your house, man. We're laughing, we're joking, and somebody looked at me, hey, man, we having way too much fun to be unemployed.
Yeah.
And
Let's do something with this.
And somebody else pops up, hey, there's a new comedy club opening up.
Yep.
And somebody says, hey, why don't you go there?
Why don't you try?
And I'm like, yeah, okay, whatever. But literally, that, you're right. It was like the beginnings, humble beginnings from, like, I had no plan. Nothing was on the agenda. You know, so you never know how life is going to take a turn and following through with what it is that you do. I tell you the best thing, the big props to mom.
Ladies and gentlemen, get ready because I'm not going to be able to talk. Go ahead.
I got to do big props to mom.
Get to play the music on.
I know, right? Give me the red light.
There you go.
Big props to my mom. Let me tell you what happened, dude. The day that I decided to quit my job, you know, I had the job with benefits. I was bona fide.
You were doing good.
I was doing it, man. I was a new married man with
all
a baby. I had benefits on my job, and I called my mom because I had gotten this offer to sign a contract to be like the opening act at these comedy comedy clubs. So I picked up the phone and I called my mom. I go, okay, mom, you know, you've been there in the trenches. You've been praying and giving me money all through college and everything. Well, I got a good job and I got a place and I got a wife and I got a baby. I'm going to quit. I'm going to quit to make 50 bucks in a smoke-filled bar doing stand-up. And you know what her exact response was? It was the scariest call. It took me like a week to make the call. And I swear, my mom said, well, it's about time.
Wow.
That's what you call love and support, man.
That is love and
that
support.
That is
success. Well, I want you to know, everybody who knew this gentleman that you were hearing that's 50 miles an hour and going, this is what he was like in high school. We all thought, even though you didn't think, that it was going to be something related to this later on, because you haven't lost a step. This is what he was in high school. And we'll get to Captain Zapp in a moment. But let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Because some millennials who are now in their 30s are around this studio, and they heard that Nick Arcade's host was coming. And they're like, wow! Explain the impact of that now. I mean, you are now the golden years.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. They call it the golden era. They call it classic Nickelodeon. Something has happened. Over the course of the last, like, 25 years, people have evolved. People have grown. This little show that I did, I call it literally, like, the Cinderella show.
Yeah.
Because there were other shows on Nickelodeon that really had, like, tremendous backing.
Right.
Don't get me wrong. The folks at Viacom and Nickelodeon, they liked the show and they supported us. But some shows, like my show, is a show that has absolutely no merchandise you can buy.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Right,
it's like,
right,
it didn't have
right.
the, people ask, how come
there was no Phil doll?
Right, right. No Phil doll. There's no Funko
That'd
Pop of me. You know
That'd
what I mean?
Fun.
You know, there's
I'd
no t-shirt you can buy.
Yes.
And never was. And then other things, like there's no merchandise, none of that stuff. Right. Matter of fact, people ask me, how come every time they find a picture from the show, it's always blurry? Because we never had a photographer come out. We never even took publicity shots for Nick Arcade. So every picture that exists from the show is a still captured while we're shooting the show. And of course, as you know, I'm always moving.
Always. But yet, it endures.
Yeah, it did. And that's the thing, that's where I got humble. Look, this whole thing of going around doing stuff now, I actually got like chastised a little bit by folks because I did one thing and saw some people and they kept telling me, hey man, what took you so long? You know, Mark Summers from Double Dare was here, and Kirk Frog from Legends was here, the cast from All of That was here, and my answer literally was, I didn't know you cared. Like,
there
seriously,
you go, right.
I'd grown up, I'd moved on, I started working as a producer and writer in Los Angeles.
You
was
got
doing
behind
well.
The camera.
I got behind the camera. As a matter of fact, I used to tell people, you haven't seen me, but you've seen my stuff.
Right.
You know, but I made this one little appearance, and then the snowball started happening. And it's really, what I realize now is, like, 90s are the new black. And that's what's really...
I like that.
That's really cool, and I'm the
well,
old black.
I just want you to know, you impressed my producer, the professor, because first he won an Emmy.
Professor!
He said you won an Emmy in 2001.
Yes, I did. I won an Emmy for not Nickelodeon.
There you go. For not Nickelodeon.
But yeah, man, so it's really weird. Now all of a sudden I feel like I'm the B. Arthur of Nickelodeon.
As a matter of fact, you kind of look like her. Mustache and all.
Thank you for being my friend.
But when it comes to, though, Phil, what you would tell, and I, you know, we have children now who are grown, is that never give up on this stuff, because
now,
you never know when an opportunity is going to present itself.
Right. Also, look, two things. Never give up on this stuff. You don't know. And number two, don't be surprised if there's a paradigm shift in your life.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not necessarily a bad thing. Like I said, I invested a lot of time, a lot of money, and I had a support group of people that were backing me while I went on this journey to become an engineer at Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University,
yes,
only to throw it away after getting a job
to
make 50 bucks in a bar,
there you go.
And it evolved into what has now become a 25-year career.
Wow.
You know, you can't
amazing.
Even... Now, this thing now with this retro, this is what's really tripping me out, because all the little 14-year-olds,
yes,
they're now grown up.
Right.
So now they're in their 30s.
And they have money to spend.
They have money to spend, but the thing is, their heart and their mind, one of the biggest things, look, when I talk with these cast, these guys from back in Nick of the Day, we all talk about the biggest thing we are, like, blown away by is people coming to us now going, I grew up on you. And I'm like, wow, that is really kind of an odd thing. You
it
know?
Makes you old.
It really does. And, like, people start asking me for child support.
Now, real quick.
That wasn't me.
Because we're going to take a break, but Phil is not going anywhere. Phil Moore is staying with me. But what's coming up is MAGFest 2018, right over there in National Harbor, Prince George's County. It is going to be January 4th through the 7th, and you will be part of it.
Yeah.
You
well, let me tell you what. The cool thing about this, a guy named Shay Alexander. What's up, Shay?
Okay.
Shay and the team of people that he gathered, I met a few of them the other day, really talented people, and they did what I call the ultimate Beatles Mania tribute thing,
right,
but for Nick Arcade.
Okay.
And they've been putting on this show in which they're doing elements that have, like, the flavor, the scent of Nick Arcade.
I smell it now.
You smell it now?
It's not good.
It smells like orange.
I'm not going.
They were doing, well, you know, Nickelodeon's colors are. You know. But they've been doing this show in which they bring people up on stage, and now they have kind of regulars who are like, you know, have been over the course of time, like WWE, like this guy versus this guy. And they've been doing this great show. And we met at Timeline Arcade in Hanover, Pennsylvania about 3 years ago. And we started talking about, like, hey, how coming about and being a part of it. And it was just a matter of timing. So the funny thing is we got together and met like a couple days ago. And the guy is like talking to me about like how to do the show. I'm like, this is like kind of a Nick Arcade thing. He goes, yeah. I said, I know how to do that. You know?